Hello folks, this is Dan Tavar of Atomontage, and today we will be doing some AI programming, also known as vibe coding. And that's why we're actually taking these glasses off, because we're not reading code today, you know what I mean? It's vibe coding is about not reading code, so I don't need those. So we'll just get started here. As always, go to atomontage.com, hit make montage, we'll get into the back end. And this is where you have your 3D world in the cloud that can be a game, it can be an experience, it can be any bunch of different use cases, honestly, but let's talk about it as a game today. You will just add one, go for the free malleable one here in the middle, it can be free forever. As soon as you have this, you could just make here, which will open it up in a browser, or you can do what we should do when we're gonna be scripting. It's actually necessary. So here we have it in the browser, that's fine. But you actually need to go share, get this URL, and then get the native client. So you go here to download on our website, stable build, you get this native client, you install it, and you're gonna be pasting that URL you grabbed before into here and connecting to that. This is the native client. It connects the same way to that place in the cloud, and you can have multiple people do this at the same time and be in there at the same time, developing and editing the world at the same time together. I will enable some shadows. Okay, when you're in this world now, how do you get started scripting here? This is what we went over in the previous video, but here is where you actually get into the AI scripting. And now you do need a specific tool. Go back to the browser, go to cursor.com, download, install this. So this may just work with our native client actually when you start scripting, but if it does not, you hit this little menu button up here, go into Lua, specify that cursor executable, and you're ready to go. Okay, so we're gonna create the head of this snake or worm, as it were. We're gonna do it with some random emoji here. Just to emphasize that everything in here is made out of voxels, we can add or remove from and to this object, of course. This is all voxels. The entire world is voxels. There's a lot of craziness going here too. The previous experimentation left behind, but let's get a new one. I just messed that one up. Happy face, nice. That'll be the head of our worm. In the previous video, we were having this be removed from the world in this kind of carve operation. So would love to be able to dig through the ground. Let's add a script to this guy. We open up the server hierarchy window here, which shows all the things that are in the world on the server side. And that's the one that we usually work in anyway. We create a new script, call it, I don't know, snake. We're adding a script component to this that is now active. Hit open on here. The snake script will now open in cursor right away, because again, we've set it to be the IDE of choice here. Now, yeah, snake.lua is here. First, we want to make sure that our context has the voxel API that we care about. It's going to be here. In the browser, we do have our documentation. It's docs.atomontage.com. Pretty easy to remember. Go here, copy this, go use this API, just paste in the URL. Now we're telling the model Claude 3.7 that we want to have the API that's in the documentation there, and it's going to parse that, index it. There's also this additional little voxel API documentation here. It's very short, but it does give some examples for the model here, again, to have in its context to know that, okay, we want to use specifically our bindings. So here the model is going through our documentation. Make the object it is attached to tunnel through voxel terrain while leaving a trail of snake in the classic game snake or worm, but in 3D. Use this API for that, this voxel API specifically, and give it that. So it's very cool to see the thinking thought process of the latest Claude 3.7 actually going through this reasoning process. User wants me to implement snake already has the basic structure. Yes, great. Voxel mutation. Yep. Let me plan the doc. Okay, so here we go. Boom. Vibe coding, baby. Wow. Interesting things here. Rotations. I'm not reading this code because I'm vibe coding, but you know, I'm curious enough to just skim through here to see what's going on at the highest level. But I actually don't even need to do that because it summarizes exactly what it's doing here. It's trying to give me some controls to actually control the snake and so on. But all I have to do is accept this file now, hit save, and immediately it vanished. That object is now gone. Interesting. Oh, it's moving already. Yoo-hoo! Okay, so it's moving, but is it doing anything with the terrain, you think? When we put it through the ground? Nope, it's not. Let's pause this script. There's also errors. So snake stack da 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 da, expected numbers, doesn't matter. We don't look at those. We just paste in the first error and it'll fix it, hopefully. Usually does it on the first try. I see the issue, wonderful. So he's fixing the problem now. And now there's no error anymore. We need to activate the script though. And look at that, we got a snake trail here, but we can see that it's actually causing an issue already. It's adding these dots to itself. So we'll make the tunneling actually remove the shape of the head itself. Well, first of all, make the snake motion be along the Z axis. See if it will move with the face in the right orientation here. Okay. That should do it. Accept file. Reactivate it again here. See? Wow, nice. It did it. Wonderful. Okay, script is being added to this clean one, clean emoji here, snake, great. And it is off to the races. Let's see if it does what we're hoping to see now, which is, yes, it is eating itself through the rock there and comes out in the other side. It'll just deselect it, yes. That's the effect I wanted. Awesome, here it comes, all happy. Instead of green, make the body yellow in color. Accept file. Yellow instead. Nice. We do have it kind of heating itself a little bit there. That is a little annoying. We can make it drop the... Yeah, let's do that. We'll make it drop the body balls, let's say, a little further behind. Stamp the body spheres a little further behind the head of the worm. I like the summary that it does. Key changes, and it gives us these cool variables. I think they put them kind of at the top. Yeah, look at that. That's so nice. So we can tune these parameters. That's awesome. And we'll create a new little wormy here. Okay. It's doing two colors now. We'll see when it emerges here, what it looks like. Here it is. I love how it just comes out. Well, we got a two-tone snake. Why not? Very cool. Okay, now I'd like it to do something more interesting than just going straight forward. Please make the snake turn smoothly random curves on its own. This is pretty mind-blowing. Like, we're just writing English and getting code that actually works. And it's like all AI stuff, it's 80 to 90% there usually. Almost never 100% what you want, but then you iterate. Bad argument. Okay, we'll ask it to fix that. Just copy pasting in the error, not even looking at it. There's an error, fix it, please. So we'll move this guy back over here into the fray. Accept this file. I didn't even look at the error, the fix. If anyone's connected to the server, by just clicking that URL that we have, we can share with, they're gonna see all this. They're gonna see everything that's going on here. Well, we have a problem. The worm is just vibrating. The worm is vibrating violently. Please try to make it move smoothly along sweeping curves. My kid is on the floor. Tired face. That's me right now. Add the script. Snake. Bro. Let's see. What's it doing here? It's moving. Yeah, it's doing a little wavy motion. And it's digging through the mountain here. That's what we want to see. It'll come out the other side somewhere. Somewhere? Oh, it's inside. Oh, here it is. Here it comes. Titta. Look at this. He has gone through the mountain and keeps going down here like he's got a dune worm. So here in the back end, again, we have the web client that we can connect to and see exactly what has been going on. This is what you can share. This URL is something you can share with anyone. Where was that guy? He's doing the... Here he is. He's moving all the way through all the mountains and still going here. And yep. And this shellfish jellyfish is, of course, the other client that we have here. You know, that's the one that we've been editing with. This guy is going right into the sand here. Leaving an interesting trail after himself of the shape of his body. Leaving voxels. What I wanted to point out here is that this is completely vibe coded. It's also very messy, but you know, trying to do this with polygons is really troublesome because as soon as you have too much geometry in the scene, you end up with too many polygons. You can then not run that on a phone or in a browser. It will hit certain hard limits of polygon counts in the scene. Of course, you can do LODs with polygons, but you cannot do LODs that are dynamically changed all the time when the world has tunnels being made through it and tons of this kind of stuff being added all the time. Then you have to recompute those LODs in an offline manner, which is a bit of a showstopper, honestly. With our solution here, you don't need to worry about polygon counts because there's no polygons in here. There are voxels only in the entire world, including the characters, including the vehicles, and whatever else is in here is all these microvoxels that are streamed from the server to multiple clients, many clients that are connected at the same time, tunneling through here, through that with his ding dong, whatever that is, hanging, and he's got some hair or something. But yeah, the script is working. It was completely vibe coded. I did essentially not look at the code whatsoever. It's mind blowing to make this worms-like character move along and dig a hole in whatever it's going through and also leave a trail of these voxels. And it can keep adding trails of these very detailed geometry. There's no hard limits here. It's all voxel data that can just be added to or removed from kind of endlessly. So you have the ability to have these kind of bots or agents run around in here doing things even when you're not connected. The server will keep running and you can have the scripts running doing things in here. So you could imagine having a bunch of these worms that might chase each other, or they might eat each other's bodies, or you know, the classic worms or snake game, but in 3D now. So you see the beginning of this here. This is just kind of a quick intro on how to do this kind of AI driven programming. And it's not just driven, it's like completely AI vibe coding, as they call it. We're gonna have another video probably after this where we start generating with prompts more geometry, actually, so we can have interesting things happen with, you know, descriptions of the characters or the things and the objects in the world that you want to get added to your character. Let's say you're adding horns or something, you can actually describe, give me a curved horn or a top hat or whatever on this guy, and it'll actually create that for you using some of our partners that can generate models from text prompts. There he is. So this is the quick tutorial on how to get vibe coding going with microvoxels on the Atomontage platform. It's all happening in the cloud. The simulation is happening in the cloud and it's being served up to these different individual devices in a very efficient way and rendered on them locally. So we're not rendering server side. It's much more efficient. We can be much more generous with our free montages here that are free basically forever. If you want higher resolution and so on, then you can pay for a premium montage, but you're going to get very far with the free one, just like this one is, and be able to build some really interesting, compelling things and share them with your friends or the world through a simple URL. So until next time.